Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel and let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. We're gonna start from the new game's announcements, which is Tempus 84. This game is a time traveling game because that's what they're doing. And what's happening is you are a time traveler, but also you have to keep your brain in gear because it's first person adventure game with the elements of strategy and experience. There will be combat as well. You're gonna have your initial experimental team, whatever they're doing, they're gonna be helping you out. You will have to keep your equipment maintained and fight the rogue elements, and in general survive the shit that was thrown at you. Now, the developer saying this is the trailer that is older, it's not even like a proper trailer, I think. But next month, they will be debuting new trailer and then we're gonna find out more about this game. Time traveling in VR, I'm up for it anytime. Okay, anyway, next story, and now let's come back quickly to Audica. The new update should be out or it will be out anytime soon. And in this update, we're not only getting some free songs, but also we're getting some paid songs also. But apart from that, you'll be able to apply all the challenges what you had in campaign to your, you know, songs. When you're choosing songs, you'll be able to click and say, okay, I want this challenge and I want to play it like this. And the game is like, okay, yeah, let's do it. So if you own Audica, very fun rhythmic shooter slash very fun rhythmic game in general game. So yeah, if you own it, you're gonna get some free cool stuff. Okay, next story and Europeans, if you're missing some games on the store, Viking Days is out in Europe now. It's been out in US now for a while, not so good. But basically you're living like a daily living of Vikings and you're doing Vikingy stuff. Like throwing hammer and other strange activities, what Vikings apparently used to do. Not the biggest game, but also not very expensive. I never played it, I'm not planning on to, but maybe you might like it, I don't know. So you'll be able, you are able actually to check it out now. Okay, and next story, now this is rumors. I always like to comment on rumors, but also I always like to say to you many of them are not true. But I like to pass them on because it's probably something what you're gonna start reading soon in many other articles, especially that it's regarding Resident Evil 8, a very big game that everyone is waiting for. And of course, for us PSVR owners, Resident Evil 7 still probably one of the best, if not the best VR games. Such an achievement, a this generation game put in VR and it's done properly, awesome game. But anyway, what's happening with new Resident Evil 8 rumors? There was shitloads of them, they always changing. The latest one saying that this game gonna have return of Ethan from the last Resident Evil, so he's gonna be there. Also, Chris Redfield will return in some shape or form. The action apparently gonna take place in the village. Nice. And this will lead you up into a castle. So they say it's gonna be like snowy environments and stuff. Apparently Europe, that's what I'm hearing. There will be no more molded, but instead there will be zombies. They're gonna make return, very nice return welcomings, because zombies gonna be feel better. It's gonna be better variety of them, if that's true anyway. But also what they saying is that there will be some ghost character that gonna follow you, like be stalking you all the time, adding the tension to you, to your experiences. And once you shoot this character, it will disappear. Also, there will be some werewolf-like creatures. It's gonna take place in the first person like the last one, and also apparently this game was tested last year, so apparently that's what's happening with Resident Evil franchise. Now listen, there was shitloads of rumors about Resident Evil 8. Some been saying that it's been cancelled and they have to restart it and redo it again. Different leaks and stuff. This one, the latest one, I just want to pass it on. And apparently it's gonna be revealed, listen, next month at the reveal of PlayStation 5, because apparently PlayStation 5 is going to be revealed in February, but that's not even true. Well, it might be true, but that's another rumor. And I like to say about the rumors, anyone can say anything they want. The rumors always pointing to some sort of industry insider of or a friend of industry insider. There's always tiny bit of truth of them. Maybe somebody guessed something, I don't know. But just passing it on there, that's the latest rumors. You might be reading about it in other articles. Take everything with pinch of salt, because of course, even, no, you know, it sounds good. It might not even be happening, or it might be happening. Anyway, I'm gonna put link in the description to the source so you can look. Yeah, so you can look at it by yourself. That's what I meant to say. Right, okay. If you like what you've seen, then please press a like because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.